like we always do at this time. What up, everybody? Now, this happened like 2 days ago. But let me explain to you the logistics of what the fuck has happened. Now, y'all remember that NBA Youngboy did drop a diss record. He been dissing O Block since he been home. True or false? Yes or no? Yes. He fucking diss Bootsy. Little Bootsy. And voila, like Bootsy said, he don't call phones, shots. NBA Youngboy is back in jail, y'all. Ain't that a motherfucker? Now, I can get into why he went to jail, but this message that's being conveyed by this podcaster and the name of his show is, because I'm going to use some of his content, but it's a little bit off, and I'm going to tell you why it's off. They point fingers at Dirk. Nah, Dirk could have been did this if Dirk was going to do this here. Notice when he says something to Boosie, district trended. So if y'all, I'm going to subscribe to him too because I like that. And I'm going to get all notifications. Boom. This is district trending. So if y'all want to, y'all go check out the whole video because as you see, I'm not even going to play the whole video, right? Now check this shit out. Listen.
Message, NBA Youngboy asks the fans to let him suffer in peace. This was until one of his lawyers realized that the feds illegally arrested NBA Youngboy. They ended up using footage from his cameraman that they were not allowed to as they didn't have a warrant for it. This wasn't enough to get the case completely thrown out, but it was enough to get NBA Youngboy a deal to get him released on house arrest around 3 months ago. NBA Youngboy returned home. He went straight to work, releasing hits such as Safe Then Sorry, Bring the Hook, and No Switch. There's now reports of NBA Youngboy being taken into jail, awaiting his trial, which is officially May 16th, and this could be due to him breaking his house arrest agreement. NBA Youngboy had lots to say about Lil Durk and many other rappers in the industry, such as Gucci Mane, Boosie.
Boosie. Boosie. I'm telling you, you know what? I disrespect Boosie and the motherfuckers can't lock me up. They had shit to do with nothing. But I'm telling you, hey, that man said something about Boosie, and voila, his motherfucking conditions of release has been violated. He's going to court on May 16th for a weapons charge. I mean, all these people, and note one thing, note one thing, note one thing. I have some music got to do before he went to jail, didn't he? And note one more thing. When the other rappers like Boss Top said something, and notice Boss Top is not OTF, no big deal. Notice that when Boss Top said something, motherfucking, Lil Durk was like, hey, don't say shit. We're not beefing nobody. Because they knew what the flavor was. Now, let me explain to y'all one more thing that's going on that y'all should keep your eyes on. This shit is in the making. This is in the motherfucking making. Watch what I'm telling y'all. Everybody was asking the question of why was Chop dissing King Von? You know why he dissed that album from King Von? Because first of all, Chop already knew about the album from King Von because he did most of the goddamn songs on there, most of the music on there. Remember when he was telling Dirk, when he was posting online saying that he couldn't get in touch with Dirk, right? Right. He couldn't get in touch with Dirk. What they turned around and did is the stuff that him and Von created, I guess they took Chop music off of it and put other music on this. They ain't got to pay Chop too. That's why Chop is mad about that album, allegedly. I'm not saying that's 100% correct, but that's allegedly some rumors that I'm seeing and shit that I'm reading. He's mad about, not mad at King Von, he's not dissing King Von. And the album was dope as hell with him and King Von there. How could y'all change the music? Some of the music don't even go with the lyrics anymore. Not to mention, he know that a lot of those songs that Booker is on, Dirk is on, all these people is on. He know originally they wasn't on those records. He looking like, y'all really took that nigga music, stole his music, put who you want you on there, and kind of took it over and featured him on his own songs. That's why Chop is mad. So don't nobody peep that, note that, but understand one thing. When Chop start playing around with Lil Boosie, Lil Chop will meet the same fate and be a young boy. And like Lil Boosie said, he ain't got to do shit. He ain't got to do shit to top. Because y'all got to remember, Boosie was his biggest supporter. He was his biggest supporter. He even had his artist in one of his movies. I don't know what the case may be, why, but you know, like, think about this here. When niggas get into that federal shit, the papers they get, it's all any papers that you get when you got a county and a state case and all that, it's different. The shit that they see is very graphic. Maybe from 20, 10 fucking years ago, a bitch said something about you. It's gonna be in that federal paperwork. Maybe he read shit about Boosie that he didn't like. That's why he said, this man, I don't think he liked me. Because maybe he heard some of the shit that was said about him. But, you know, I don't like to see no man in jail. I'm not rooting for anybody to be in jail. Man, free NBA, man. Fuck that. NBA. Free all them boys. Free Moolah. Free goddamn thing. Free all them boys, man. I think at this point, man, we got to think of a better way to punish our black men. And I don't think that them being incarcerated is one of those ways. Goddamn, we got lots of things that need to be rebuilt. Different cities, different states. Why we can't put an ankle march on them, make them live in certain places, and make them work every day and help build up the places that need help? Why we can't do something that's meaningful? Why somebody gotta privately make money off these people's mistakes? That's bullshit. But anyway, you know, it's just me. I thank your boy Costa Don. Thank you to every last one of my motherfucking subscribers once again. Thank you to anybody who likes, shared, put feedback on the videos. Thank you. May it be good, bad, whatever, man. Whatever, man. Shout out to my boy Spadezilla. Thank you. Shout out to Trap House. Shout out to Spill the Tea. Shout out to the king of motherfucking Jersey. You already know, man. Jersey in the house without a doubt. And to any and every, my boy Marco Vasquez. Troy, where's it? Harley Quinn. Don't look down on others. You know what I'm saying? It's a ton of people, man. Much love to everybody. Thank you. Rocking with your boy, and I will be rocking right back with you. These videos got to be done, man. If I don't do it, somebody else gonna do it. So go look at the other man and get mad and hate on what they say, because half the people here say most of the same thing. But before I go, I have more. I do have more.
In Lil Baby, NBA Youngboy released his song, I Hate Youngboy, and the lyrics goes as followed. Youngboy, they're gonna get you. You better stop dissing them. Tell them guys they know I ain't scared of them. How are you talking when nothing ain't gone but your cousin them? Quando got no filter, and he say that. They gon' get with them, clean up on aisle O, youngin' let that blow. Hey, my brother let that stick blow. No, that's mine. He called.
Now think about this, right? What if Lil Durk really did put Von Head on the chopping block, right? And what if in return Boosie gotta put Youngboy Head on that chopping block too? Cause ain't that what it seemed like what's gonna happen, right? Man, not safe, bro. Now I get it. And ask yourself one more thing about NBA Youngboy. Where the fuck is OG33 at a time like this? You haven't seen OG33 not one time since they said that he went to jail for that fed charge. Where the fuck is OG33?
Called me a B. That's India. That be your girl. Now, I had to change a lot of the lyrics, but you understand the point. These lyrics are clearly a response towards Lil Durk, as Youngboy mentions Durk's cousin Nooski, and even says, "Clean up on aisle O," referring to the list of rappers that have been passing that are from O Block lately, such as Nooski, D-Thang, and King Von. Lastly, NBA Youngboy mentions Lil Durk's wife, India, calling her out for being a B. Now, NBA Youngboy has been going at Lil Durk ever since he was released on house arrest, as even 3 weeks ago, NBA Youngboy dropped his single titled Bring the Hook. Now, it's very obvious who and what this song is about. In case you missed the lyrics, let's break them down for you. These lyrics are clearly at late rapper King Von. It starts by saying, "This that Squid Game, O Block Pack get rolled up, M what they told us, Atlanta boy get fold up." So King Von isn't from Atlanta, but he...
Now I remind you, NBA Youngboy was at Kane home to get ready for his trial, be with his family, not come home and start more fucking beef. And that's what he did. And the feds is watching. The feds are watching.
He did sadly pass.
So be mindful of the things that you write in these comments to understand. I'm going to say this again. Watching, man.
While in Atlanta, as Von ran into Quando Rondo, otherwise known as a rapper, signed to NBA Youngboy's label at a club. NBA Youngboy was told to stay out of beef and any trouble while he was out on house arrest. Yet, the first week he's on house arrest, he ends up sending a ton of beef over to Chicago rappers and almost every other rapper in the music industry. And that's why at the time of this recording, on March 8th, we got news that NBA Youngboy has been taken back into jail to await his trial to start. Law enforcement most likely doesn't...
If I'm not mistaken, who was that he was standing talking in front of? Was that Howard Goetzel? Walter Cronkite, one of the motherfuckers, because both of them is federal agents that he was in front of, whichever one it was.
On NBA Youngboy to have the access to a microphone anymore, as he's just going to cause more issues for himself going forward. NBA Youngboy was supposed to use his time on house arrest to stay close to his family and to get ready for his trial. But the only thing he has been doing is causing tons of beef online and say a lot of very interesting things in his lyrics of his music. So there was an update on why NBA Youngboy could be sentenced to 7 years in prison. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like.
We enjoyed the video. Thank you, buddy. Okay, now you can haul ass. We're done with you. Get the fuck off. But listen, right? Take this out, right? Think about this shit, right? All these niggas talking about they're gonna do the NBA Youngboy this, that, and the third, right? He's going back to jail. They say he's facing 7 years. 7 years.
The only thing he has been doing is causing tons of beef online and say a lot of very interesting.
And I remind you, some of the shit that he said in these songs, the new songs, which he's talking about King Von, which is a open murder case, and you gave details that only the fucking killer would know. Just like when that boy said that two victims dead ain't nothing new. Two victims that make it through. All that bullshit you said, that's an open case. You got a fair case. That's why they snatched him back up. You know more. You know more. That's why he said never free again. One case of 7 years. Watch the new cases they gonna pull up on NBA. And it's sad because you know what it's called? Of snitching. Rappers, MCs, fucking dumbass niggas that own these fucking record labels. All you punk motherfuckers. Stop letting your artists self-snitch on themselves and self-destruct while you sit back and collect their royalties and their money while they're in jail. That's why I get $10,000 a month, but the motherfucker making $100,000 a month. So who's really coming off? To my young brothers, if you're a rapper, go independent, man. Fuck that. BMI. ASCAP. United Masters. Talk to my man Spacezilla. He could actually, if y'all know who he is, go look. He's one of my moderators. Go talk to Spacezilla. He could help you on that shit. He could actually give you pointers how to start your own shit. Don't do. Y'all gotta get on point. Spiller T, much love. You already know I always got you on mine. That's my confidant. But you know, back to what I'm saying. Get y'all shit on point. Don't let these record labels pimp you, dog. Pimp your own stuff. Somebody, like my man said, somebody gonna fuck your music, let it be you. It's your boy Constantine, I salute you. I would hate to shoot you. And before I go, like we always do at this time, peace.